Garter, King of Arms.
Thus it hath pleased Almighty God to take out of this transitory life unto his divine mercy the late most high, most mighty, and most excellent Princess Elizabeth, Queen Dowager and Queen Mother, Lady of the Most Noble Order of the Garter, Lady of the Most Ancient and Most Noble Order of the Thistle, Lady of the Imperial Order of the Crown of India, Grand Master and Dame Grand Cross of the Royal Victorian Order, upon whom had been conferred the Royal Victorian Chain, Dame Grand Cross of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, Dame Grand Cross of the Most Venerable Order of the Hospital of St. John of Jerusalem, Relict of His Majesty King George the VI, and Mother of Her Most Excellent Majesty Elizabeth the II, by the grace of God, of the United Kingdom, of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and of her other realms and territories, Queen, Head of the Commonwealth, Defender of the Faith, Sovereign of the Most Noble Order of the Garter, whom may God preserve and bless with long life, health, honor, and all worldly happiness.
Prelude and Fugue in E-flat by Johann Sebastian Bach. Played by Andrew Reed, the sub-organist of Westminster Abbey. The conductor of the music was James O'Donnell, who is the organist and master of the choristers here. Now the insignia will be brought down from the high altar. of the thistle was ordered secretly by King George VI and presented as a gift to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth on the evening of her coronation. The Dean of Windsor, the Right Reverend David Connor, the Reverend Anthony Burnham, Cardinal Cormac Murphy O'Connor, the Archbishop of York, the Archbishop of Canterbury behind the Cross of Canterbury, the Cross of Westminster, the Taperers, and to this triumphant music, once again these young Irish guardsmen take upon their shoulders their precious burden. The youngest only 18 years of age. Slowly, the coffin is turned about. And with the crown surmounting it, the crown which Queen Elizabeth wore for the first time in this very building at her coronation in 1937. And the congregation bow their heads, ladies curtsy. The Queen wanted this to be a triumphant celebration.